Meanwhile, as Israel and the United States beginning new partnerships in the region, the Biden administration finally throwing around some potential names for the still vacant ambassador to Israel position. And Thomas Nides, a former State Department official, now emerging at the top of that list. Here to discuss what that means is expert on the Middle East and United States-Israel ties, former Israeli ambassador to the United States, Yoram Ettinger. Yoram, Ambassador, thank you so much for being with us. Now, Nides, who is Jewish, is supposedly known to have pro-Israel sensibilities. How does he compare, though, to Trump's ambassador to Israel, David Friedman, who some go so far as to characterize as biased towards Israel?
Both are extremely different from one another. Unlike Ambassador Friedman, who understood that Israel's control of the Golan Heights would serve, does serve, America's best interest, the proposed ambassador of President Biden considers the Golan Heights to be on the negotiation table as part of Syrian-Israeli bargaining element. The Friedman administration state of mind realized that the Palestinian issue must not have a veto power over Arab-Israeli peace negotiation. On the other hand, the proposed ambassador considers the Palestinian issue to be a central issue in the Middle East, in Arab politics, and the crux of the Arab-Israeli conflict, none of which have anything to do with reality. And certainly, the proposed ambassador by President Biden is more or less a copy-paste of the Department of State worldview. Namely, when it comes to the Iran's Ayatollahs, there should not be a regime change. There should not be any extra pressure on the Ayatollahs. And just like Secretary of State Tony Blinken, just like National Security Advisor Jake Sullivan, and just like President Biden.
So again, maybe let's go a little bit deeper into what you were just talking about. How does the Palestinian Authority and Iran really fit into the grand scheme of Middle East security and foreign policy with respect to Israel and the United States? Do you have any predictions on the effect that Nides will have in dealing with the threats that these entities pose?
Well, there's no doubt that the new ambassador, and by the way, regardless who the new ambassador will be, that new ambassador will reflect the worldview of the president and the worldview of Secretary Blinken, who literally, basically sets a foreign policy, national security policy of the Biden administration. And as such, the new ambassador to Israel will provide tailwind to the Palestinian Authority, possibly will raise the energy of Hamas in Gaza, and certainly will bolster the pressure on Israel to retreat from the mountain ridges of Judea and Samaria.
Effectively speaking, though, do you see that Israel is going to be put in a dangerous position, or at the end of the day, will Israel's safety come to the fore and be considered?
Well, it's going to revert back to the pre-Trump administration routine, the routine which prevailed from Truman in 1948 all the way through the Obama-Biden administration, which ended in January 2017, namely a routine replete with disagreements, friction, sometimes punishment, just like suspension of supply of military hardware, combat planes, etc. However, that routine also featured the very unique cooperation between the two countries, because stronger than misperception by the foreign policy establishment in Washington, the misperception about the Middle East, much stronger is the reality of the stormy Middle East, the stormy world, which highlight the unique benefits drawn by the U.S. from Israel, which in this stormy atmosphere constitutes the most reliable and effective and democratic ally of the U.S., which constitutes a force multiplier extending the hand of the U.S. without requiring additional American soldiers. And my assessment is we're going to see more and more tension and disagreement, but at the same time, more and more realization.
All right, Ambassador Ettinger, thank you so much.
Thank you.